Did you get a look at his face?
Yes, but I haven't seen him before.
Okay, try not to talk. Eric!
Well,
what? Did you catch him?
No, he was too quick. Are you okay?
Yes, thanks again. Eric, does this mean that up to now, Rosa still wants to kill me?
I talked to my contacts, Maningning. I told them to find that man whom you just described. He won't get far.
I'll go down to the station to ask help from Armand. Maningning, I think it's best that you take a rest.
That's what I've been telling you. I told you to be careful.
But it still doesn't matter even if I am careful. Eric was with me the whole time, but someone still tried to kill me. I think they're even bolder now, Mother.
I think you need a bodyguard. Do you want me to be your bodyguard? Why not?
You, my bodyguard? You can't even protect me from Cheetah.
You know what? She's right. How about me, Maningning? How about me? I'll be your bodyguard.
Wait a minute here. I'm not the president. And besides, you have your own lives to live. You can't just follow me all the time.
Okay.
Well, if you're going to ask me, Myrna, I would just lock her up inside my house so that she won't get into trouble.
That's too much.
Put her in a box.
Thank you. Well, why don't we ask help from somebody who helped you while you were in jail?
Who are you talking about, Virgie?
It's Harry.
Mother, even if my life depends on it, I would never ask help from Harry.
Sigmund, what happened to you? Don't you think you're too old to get into juvenile fights?
It's nothing, Mother. It's just a small traffic accident the other day.
If that's the case, why are you still in a foul mood?
Because it still hurts.
Oh well, do whatever you want.
Did you really get that from an accident, Father? Or from an enemy?
I'm not in the mood for this. Don't talk to me.
I'm just concerned, Father.
Hello? You have to be careful with Harry. We got into a fight the other day.
Maningning doesn't want to see you. Come back some other time.
But what about my offer to help her?
Well, she said it herself. She told me she doesn't want to accept any help coming from you.
All right. But if she changes her mind, you know where to find me, okay?
Mm-hmm. Virgie.
Oh, Armand.
Virgie.
Come in.
Good morning. Is Maningning here?
Yes, she is. Maningning?
Mother!
Come over here. Armand wants to talk to you.
Hi, Maningning.
Hi. Armand, I was about to go to the station because you might need information to capture the man who attacked me last night.
Oh, well, that's exactly why I'm here. I know that you're taking a rest, so I brought my teammate. This is Raffi. He's our cartographic artist. He can sketch the man who assaulted you last night, based simply on your description.
That's cool.
Yes, that would really help in catching that man.
Okay, excuse me.
Yes, madam.
Armand?
Yes, Virgie.
Wait a minute. I just noticed. There's something different about you. It seems you look so happy today. It looks like...
Really?
You have a different look today. What happened? What is it?
Oh.
Mother!
Hmm?
You're making him uncomfortable. Stop doing that to Armand. He's already helping us out, you know.
Well, I'm just asking. Because it's really obvious.
Okay, Virgie. Perhaps it would be better if you heard it from me than from someone else. Well, it's Sandy. She accepted my proposal to marry her.
You're getting married?
I'm getting married.
Wow. I'm so happy for you, Armand. Congratulations.
Thanks, Moneyning.
What now? Are you looking for Sandy again?
Of course not.
Come on, Habagat. Well, I'm sorry about that. It's too late.
What do you mean? Why? Sandy already left?
I thought so. I was right. You're looking for Sandy. I told you it's too late because Sandy already said yes to Armand. Now they're getting married.
Habagat.
Sandy, you don't have to keep it a secret from him. I just told him the truth. And I really need to go, because I think both of you need to talk. And as for me, I don't want to take part in this drama, because believe me, I'm not a big fan of that.
Congratulations.
I'm sorry. You had to hear it from Cheetah. I didn't know how to tell you the news.
That's okay. Does this mean that I don't have a chance to win you over? If there's no place for me in your heart, can we? Could we still be friends?
Habagat, are you sure do you want to be friends with me?
You're right. Okay. Good luck to you and Armand. My friend is a good man. He'll take good care of you.
Charles, any news?
About Mother? Nothing new. I really can't forgive myself for what I've done. I shouldn't have let her escape.
It's already done, Charles. Ning Ning has forgiven you. Don't beat yourself too hard.
Thank you, Eric. How's Ning Ning, by the way?
That's what brought me here. Someone tried to kill Ning Ning last night. Wherever Rosa is, I don't think that she and Cassandra will stop trying to kill Ning Ning.
Excuse me. Hello? Hello?
Who's this? Hello?
Wrong number.
How's my granddaughter, Virgie?
Well, she's safe for now. She's staying at home, and I made sure she won't go out because I asked Habagat to keep an eye on her. Who knows, she might have a run-in again with the person who wants to kill her.
If you need someone to watch over Ning Ning, I can get someone.
Sigmund is right, Virgie. Ning Ning badly needs a bodyguard, especially now.
Madam Consuelo, you know your granddaughter. You know that she would not agree to having a bodyguard.
But her life is in grave danger. So what do you think we should do?
We're only after the thugs here. We need to get to the mastermind. It's Rosa. I still believe that Rosa is the person behind everything that is happening to Ning Ning. Once we get Rosa, Ning Ning will surely be out of danger. If it's possible, Madam Consuelo, I ask you to please do whatever you can to find that crazy woman.
Yes, I'll do that. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Just a piece of advice. If you really want to find where Rosa is, you have to start with your granddaughter, Cassandra.
Hey, what's this? What's the commotion? What's happening? Let me in. What's happening? What happened? What?
Floating in the water for a while.
Is this the first time that they found
this? When did this happen? Just now? Oh my!
I wonder who it is.
Is it dead?
Gia!
What is that?
Just look, this is really shocking. Oh my, we see dead men floating around here nowadays. Look, do you see that?
It's not another murder.
Shocking. Utterly shocking. Who could he be?
Looks like a holdup or something. So.
And he
went wrong.
Who is that?
Eric. That's the man who attacked me.
You said you could do it, Rosa. When am I going to see the dead body of my wretched sister?
Well, it seems that she's really a cat after all.
But don't worry.
I have other plans. Many, many plans.
And what other plans do you have that will surely fail?
Well,
if Meng Ning is really a cat, then I'll have to end all of her 9 lives.
And if I can't finish them all off,
then let's see how tough her loved ones will be. She took my family away from me, then I'll do the same thing to her.
Let me take you home.
No, thanks. I can go home by myself. Goodbye.
Virgie!
You animal! You animal! Come back here!
That animal.
Don't mind him. Let him go. Are you all right?
Yes.
You're hurt.
I'm okay. It's just a scratch. That animal, he almost killed me. He didn't even...
Do you want me to go after him?
No need. No need. It's just a scratch. Look.
Can
it stings a little.
Now?
That won't be necessary. I don't have a sprain. It's just a scratch. Goodbye.
Are you sure?
I'm heading home, that stupid driver. Bye.
Seriously?
Meng Ning's family? Does that include me?
But of course not. Why would you think I'd do that?
Meng Ning
doesn't consider you part of her family. Am I right?
That's true. Anyway, I hope to see you soon. Bye, Rosa.
Cassandra, I heard you talking on the phone. I hope it's not Rosa.
And why would I talk to Rosa? I told you, Grandmother. You know, they're making things up to link me to that murderer, Rosa. If you must know, I was on the phone with the hospital. I'm checking on your daughter-in-law, Eleanor. At least I remember her. How about you? You may have forgotten about her already.
Why, you little brat!
Armand, does the police have anything to do with this man's death?
This is the only time that I've seen him. Meng Ning, did this man attack you last night?
Yes.
Well, based on initial investigation, someone had him killed.
My goodness. But Armand, who could do this, and why was he killed?
Well, we're trying to find out.
Whoever did this, we should probably be thanking him.
Oh, wait till they hear this. I'm going now.
Our bosses are up against each other again. What do we do?
You're right. I can't just leave Sir Sigmund. And if I do, I'm sure I'll get killed.
Same here. I just can't leave Harry. He's not only going after me, he'll go after my family.
If we find ourselves in a fight, let's just avoid each other,
okay? Absolutely. We don't sell each other out.
Of course. You saved my life after all. Deal?
Wait, could you just look at him? It's like he didn't hear anything. Aren't you worried about your sister, Mani Ning? She might get caught between Sir Sigmund and Harry's fight.
Take it easy.
Of course I'm worried. She's my sister.
Yes, take it easy now. And don't be so hard on him. He's broken-hearted. Hey, were you invited to the wedding of Armin and Sandy?
Hey, you said to take it easy on him. And you're the one annoying him.
I'm not annoying him, am I? Sorry. I'm not annoying you, Habagat. How are you? Are you okay? Really?
I'm good. I really don't have a choice but to accept everything, right?
Let's just go out and have a good time. There are some pretty girls in the next neighborhood. They sure are pretty.
Oh boy, they are pretty.
Some tourists?
Yes.
What do they look like?
Pretty.
Ooh,
really pretty.
Pretty, I like
Very
that.
Pretty.
How about you? You want to join us?
Come on.
Come with us.
No, you two go. I'll just stay here.
Okay. Were they pretty?
Oh yes.
Were they hot?
Hot, yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, they're hot.
Oh, how many were there?
Let's just go. That's they're great. Hot. Let's go.
Oh, wow.
All right, let's just go.
Okay.
Hi, Mother.
Hi.
I'm glad you remembered me. I was beginning to think that my family's forgotten me.
No, I've just been busy these past few days. How are you?
Okay. I'm still insane. Did I scare you, Mother? I was just pulling your leg. I'm sorry if I scared you. You know what? I've been dying to tell you a secret.
And what is this secret, Eleanor?
I have figured it all out. I'm really not sick, Mother. It's all Cassandra's fault. It's just her and those darn pills. She's the reason why I'm held up here, Mother.
Cassandra? Is this one of your hallucinations, Eleanor?
Mother, I am not hallucinating. I'm telling you the truth.
Okay, so where are those darn pills?
Well, I've finished it all up. Mother, you cannot blame me. I was addicted to it.
Come on. Still, you don't have any evidence against Cassandra. I knew it. This is just another one of your lies. I will just come back when there's enough sense to talk to you.
Mother, Mother, please don't go. Mother,
I'm sorry.
Please. Mother,
I'm
this
sorry,
place is
Eleanor.
Full of crazy people.
I'm sorry.
Even the doctors are
Eleanor.
Crazy.
Eleanor.
Mother, please.
I'm
Mother,
sorry.
Please
Eleanor.
Don't
Let's
leave
go.
Me.
Go.
Mother, please. I'm calm begging down. You. Don't leave
please.
Me.
Stop.
Mother,
you here
please don't
down.
Leave me.
Let
Mother, let
like
me go. Mother, please.
That's enough.
Do they have a suspect?
None, Virgie.
Mani Ning, what's the matter? This is good news. Why do you look sad? What's on your mind?
Because the man who tried to kill me is dead. Now it's impossible to ask who hired him, if it was Cassandra or Rosa or... Mayor Violetta.
You know, the truth will come out. Just like the way the dead body surfaced. It may be lost out at sea, but it will soon come out eventually.
Your words finally made sense, Myrda.
I always make sense. You just need time to understand me.
You might be right.
Mother. Mother, what happened to you? Why do you have cuts and bruises?
It's nothing. I got them when I was out in Sigmund's house. I almost got hit by a van. We tried to go after it, but it just ran off. What a coward.
Sir, any news?
Just be careful. Harry may be up to something no good again. Are you still friends with Octopus?
Yes.
Well, I don't trust that friend of yours. I want you to keep an eye on him. I want to get information from him about the plans of Harry. Is that clear?
I'll try my best, sir.
What do you mean, try?
I mean, I'll do my best, sir.
Good answer. I just spoke with Virgie. She doesn't want to go near their place because of what happened. But I'm getting worried about Meng Ning. I want you to watch over her. I want you to be the bodyguard of Meng Ning.
But sir, I've beaten you to it. I've already pitched the idea to Meng Ning. It's too bad that she rejected my offer.
But still, you shouldn't have agreed. What's the use of your skills if you don't even use them? Because if it's not Harry, then we should expect Rosa or Cassandra to try and kill her. Bukol, you keep an eye on Meng Ning. If anything bad happens to her, you'll have to answer to me.
Hello? Hello? Look, I know this is the same person who has been calling me again and again, so please, if you don't have anything to say, just stop bothering me, okay? Please, just leave me alone.
Charles? Baby boy?
Mother?
Do you feel any anger or resentment towards Armand because of Sandy?
It's not Armand's fault, right? The thing is, she chose him over me.
Looks like my brother has finally grown up to be a real man.
Why? Anything new?
Do you really want me to answer that question?
No, thanks.
You know, Habaga, it is really time that... that you start forgetting about Sandy and start looking for someone else.
I just can't. Even if I have accepted all this, it's not that easy to forget Sandy. Meng Ning, if Eric found somebody new, could you forget him that easily? I still love Sandy, Meng Ning. Even though her heart now belongs to someone else. For me, it's still her. It would take a long time for me to forget how I feel.
Mother, when are you coming back?
Why? Do you miss me?
I want you to get back here and
pay for all the crimes you committed. Tell me, Mother. Do you have anything to do with what's happening to Meng Ning?
What are you saying? I'm out of the country, my baby boy. I cannot do what you are saying. I'm very sorry for all that I did, Charles, and that's the truth.
If you're really sorry, you'll have to go back here.
But I will be in jail, and I do not want that. I love you so much, Charles.
But I cannot do what you want me to do.
Forgive me, son.
Are you really sure that you want to get Harry's help, Elena? We both want revenge on Father, Auntie. Can you just think about it first? I just learned, in the course of my friendship with Rosa, Harry is a dangerous man to deal with, whether he's your friend or enemy.
I know what I'm doing, Auntie.
Besides, I'm ready in case we have a problem.
Don't tell me that I didn't warn you, Elena.
It doesn't matter how brave I am, I still feel a great amount of fear whenever I face Harry.
It will take more than him to scare me, Auntie. I only see opportunity. An opportunity to take down the man who ruined the life of my mother and your sister.
Ideal.
Harry? Can I talk to you for a minute?
Virgie, it's a miracle. What brings you here? Hey, please excuse us.
Yes, sir.
Did you have anything to do with the death of the man who tried to kill Meng Ning?
I'm sorry. It won't happen again. I'll make it up to you. I promise. I have 4 people we can use against Meng Ning. I will not fail you. Thank you very much for this chance.
What are you doing here? Didn't I tell you that you can't come here to my house? Are you stupid? Are you deaf or just plain dumb?
Sir, sorry, my mobile phone is not working, so we need to come and see you. You told us that it's important for you to know the results of the transaction.
What happened?
Sir, our client has agreed to our price. They'll be getting drugs from us and not from anybody else.
Hello, Auntie.
Why? Did you see the floating body?
Yes, at the port.
Well, so what if I was the one who had him killed? Why, do you feel sorry for the man? Didn't he threaten your daughter? You should be thanking me for this, because somehow, somebody finished him off for you.
So you had him killed. I should be thanking you.
Why do you want me to admit this? What, are you telling the police? You know, Virgie, you should be content that you know this. Just be happy about it. At least we trimmed down the number of people who want to kill Meng Ning. Well, do you have anything to say? Well, I have other things to do.
You had a pass with Rosa, right?
Hold on. What does that have to do with what we're talking about?
Because we think that Rosa is one of our suspects behind everything that's been going on. Also, the threat to Meng Ning's life. Now, if you really want to help us, bring her back here and let her face all of the charges.
Does this mean that you're accepting my help?
No. Let's just forget about it.
Too bad. But since you've mentioned Rosa, I want you to know that I've been looking for her for some time now. Don't worry. When I see her, I'll surely let you know. All right?
We don't have to look far to find ways to make my dear father suffer.
Sir, we're very sure about
it. I know something that can really destroy him.
Very well. You can all leave.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, sir. We'll go ahead. Let's go.
Hi, Father.
Meng Ning.
Hey, watch it.
No,
hey,
let me do that for
you. Acting weird.
Come on.
No, you're a weakling. This is all muscle. It just doesn't show.
You're so full of yourself. Let me do it.
No, let me do it.
Wait a minute. Can you two just stop? Let me have that.
No.
I have been doing this since you boys were still in diapers. Just let me have that. Just give it to me.
No, Meng Ning.
No. No.
We'll carry it for you.
Yes, we'll do it.
Don't worry.
We'll do it.
We have it covered.
We'll carry it
for
you.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, if you insist.
Don't strain yourself too much. You might get
you
tired.
Don't strain yourself too much. You're a weakling.
How are you?
Fish. Hey, fish.
Hey.
You too?
Hey.
Wow, Lord. It looks like you boys are possessed.
Come on, you make it sound like we're not nice.
Isn't that a good thing? Oh, no.
What do we have here? The market is noisy now that Mining Ning and her boys are back here.
Naturally, Cheetah, we're in a market. It's really noisy here. Usually the noise comes from your big mouth. They just won't stop.
I can't tell which one smells worse, the place or this one. Ow!
I'm going now. Oh, Mining Ning, I'm happy that you're back.
Now, is that
now,
sincere?
Now, wait a minute. It looks like everyone here is acting a little too strange. What's going on
what
with him?
What happened to Cheetah? It must have been something again. She ate.
He sounds so different. It's not him talking. Look at him.
What's the matter, Habagat? I left you cleaning the house. I came back and you're still at it. My goodness, don't you think that you're overdoing it?
Not really, Mother.
Okay, rest for a while. Have some snacks.
Yeah.
I bumped into a friend of mine. You know what? She showed me her daughter's picture. She's pretty. She's taking up nursing and she has no boyfriend. It's just funny. She even mentioned to me that if she were to choose anybody to go out with her daughter, she told me she'd choose you. It's you, Habagat. She will be throwing out a party soon, and we are invited. She wants you to be there to meet her daughter.
You can go without me, Mother.
What's wrong with you? Why are you locking yourself in this house? Whenever your friends come over to ask you to go out, you won't go with them. Are you sure that you're okay?
Don't you worry. I don't have any problems.
Habagat, why don't you just go back to school and continue your studies? Finish your studies. Besides, Sandy's out of your life. You don't have any obligation. It's best that you finish your studies so that you will have a good future.
Don't worry, Mother. I'll enroll again. On the next semester.
Really?
Of course, Mother. You're absolutely right. Nothing's going to happen to me if I don't do anything, right? Besides, I'm the man in our family. I don't want to be a burden to all of you.
Come here.
How's Cheetah's house help? You're lucky that he doesn't spread rumors about you.
Mining Ning, come in. Take a seat.
Sandy, you're like a sister to me. Don't think that I'm mad at you. You don't have to be afraid of me.
Sorry, Mining Ning.
Don't apologize either. You were just following your heart, right? You're marrying Armand because you love him. Am I right? Hey, why can't you say anything? Do you have a problem?
But love can be learned, right, Mining Ning?
I know I'm not in any position to ask. But Sandy, marriage is a very big step. Now, if you're really not sure...
Mining Ning, I'm sure that I want to marry Armand.
Even if you don't love him? Sandy, whatever it is that made you want to marry Armand, because simply, it was the right thing to do. It's okay, you have my support. But I just hope that you won't regret it in the end. There are things in this world that sometimes we have to do because we know that it's right. You know that I love my brother very much, right? I don't want him to get hurt too. Now, if you really want to marry Armand, go ahead and do it. If you don't, a lot of people would get hurt. including you. I'll be going now. Congratulations to you and Armand.
You're drinking alone?
I'm sorry I didn't invite you, Eric. Here.
No thanks.
Mother called up.
Really? Did she say where she is?
She denied that she has anything to do with what's happening with Ming Ming. I really don't know if she's lying or if she feels any guilt at all.
Who is this Harry you had a fight with? Don't worry, Father. I won't tell Grandmother. Well, it's obvious that you want it to be a secret, right?
And how did you find out about Harry?
I have ears, Father. I heard you talking about him. You know, it's obvious that your tone changes whenever his name is mentioned. What started this, and why do you hate him so much?
Harry's a good-for-nothing fool. You shouldn't concern yourself too much about this, Cassandra. I'll deal with it myself.
Okay. If you insist, then, rest assured that I won't bring up this topic when we talk, Father. Have a good night.
Hey, who are you? Hey! Hey! Hey, let me go! Hey! Who are you? Hey! Anybody! Help me!
Bubol! Please! Bubol, are you okay?
Please, help me! Help me, please!
Bubol, are you okay?
Octopus!
Hey, put this out! Ah!
Octopus! Don't leave me here!
How are you?
Octopus, thank you. I really thought I was going to be toasted alive. I saw this man, he came in here.
What?
He looks familiar. He must have been sent by Harry.
What? It can't be. I was just there. They were drinking. Everybody's there.
If Harry didn't send him, who did? I can't remember if we made other enemies lately. Wait, I can't get this off. I can't remove it.
Wait. Wait, are you okay there?
No, I'm not.
I'll just get Armand.
Make it quick.
Okay.
Thanks, Octopus.
Okay. I'll be right back.
Oh, these really look nice. Oh, it's nice. There.
Where do you want to get married? Indoors or what? Here at the port?
Oh, come on, Armand. It would be better if you do a garden wedding. In a garden wedding, you'll see lots of flowers around. And you'll be close to Mother Nature. Oh, that's what I saw on TV. It's impressive, Armand.
Do we really have to talk about this now?
Come on, Sandy. Are you crazy? Of course, you have to talk about your preparations. When do you want to do that? After the wedding?
It's all right if you don't want to. It doesn't have to be today. I don't want to rush you.
No, you're not. Sorry, Armand. I was just surprised. It's because of Cheetah. He's too nosy.
Wait. Now it's my fault?
It's up to you, Armand. Anywhere you want is fine by me. What's important is that we get married. The small details are not that important.
Is that so? Well, because I really want to get married indoors. Besides, that's where weddings should take place, right?
Oh, you're right, Armand. Wonderful. An indoor wedding. Oh, that's a winner. And you know, I have a dressmaker friend who can make you the best gown. It's affordable and beautiful. You will surely be dazzling on that day, Sandy. For sure. Would that be okay with you, Armand?
Okay, that's good. Very good. It's great to have someone like you helping us plan our wedding.
You can count on me.
Well, it's getting late. I have to go. I'll see you tomorrow, Sandy. Bye. Bye, Cheetah. Thank you.
Bye, Armand. Bye. Take care. You know, Sandy, you can still back out if you're not ready. But then, Armand will surely get hurt.
The wedding is on, Cheetah.
If you say so.
Sir Harry, did you send anybody to finish off Buhol?
You know, I'm getting tired of going after Sigmund's men. From now on, I want to take down Sigmund himself. Why, what happened to your friend?
Someone tried to kill him last night. It couldn't be one from our group, right, Sir Harry?
Octopus, I know all the movements of my men. Maybe your friend messed with someone. He messed with you, right?
But he didn't do anything to anyone.
Maybe he's just lying. Believe me, I don't have anything to do with your friend. Now, if he's telling you the truth, then be careful, because we don't know if Sigmund will get back at us.
Yes, Sir Harry. I'll be going now.
I don't need your stupid flowers, Sigmund. What I need for you is to get me out of this place. Sigmund, something bad might happen to you and Mother.
Why? Did you have another dream?
No, it's Cassandra. Didn't Mother tell you that Cassandra's the reason why I'm suffering here?
Why would she do that?
Why? To seek revenge. She's been trying to get back at you for what you did to her mother. She took me down first. Mother might be next, and then you. And that explains why she's so mad at Mening Ning.
Hey, that looks good, Mening Ning. Wow.
Julie, everything that Mening Ning cooks is delicious. Right, Mening Ning?
You two are flattering me. Go ahead and eat. You know that I love you both, right? This is why I cook for you.
Wow. Looks like these two fooled you into cooking again, Mening Ning.
Oh, not really. Hey, why do you have so many things with you?
Well, these aren't for us. They're all for you.
What?
Well, Eric just told me that you've accepted his marriage proposal.
Wow, yes. Great.
You're right, but I don't think I was in the right mind when I accepted his offer.
Ning, come on.
Hey, why are you suddenly nervous?
Me? Nervous? You were practically throwing yourself at me.
How dare you? Myrna, could you hold on? I'm confused with what Eric said. Why did you bring all that food for us today?
Well, we have to bring something with us before we go to your house and ask for your mother's consent.
What?
Sir Harry, look.
Hey, maybe you're lost. Why are you here?
Is this really your turf, Harry? It's not obvious by the look of your house.
I'm not like your father who flaunts all his money and power.
Now that you've mentioned him, I want to strike a deal with you, Harry. I know that you hate him so much. I want your help in bringing down my father, Sigmund.